today we're going to look at your book, The Forgotten Trinity, and I think it is just such an appropriate topic of discussion. The title of the book is very provocative because you start off and you say it is the Forgotten Trinity. Can you say why you chose this title and why it's important to you?
Well, I think the most commonly referenced parts of that book, and it's where I said, I love the Trinity. And I said, when was the last time you heard someone say that? You'll hear them say, I love prophecy, I love the Bible, I love eschatology. I mean, you'll hear a lot of I loves, but you almost never hear anybody say, I love the Trinity. Because as soon as you say, I love something, it's sort of expected that you might feel comfortable explaining why and what that means. And even a lot of our seminary grads would struggle in sermons and in preaching and teaching to differentiate, for example, between the Father and the Son in a meaningful fashion. What's the relationship between the Father and the Son? Why did Jesus say, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father? And the fact there's so much modalism in the church, I think a large portion, at least of, I'll speak for American Christians, I think if I were to give a test on a Sunday morning in almost any large conservative Bible-believing church, I am quite concerned that over a majority of the attendees would test out as modalists. And if you specifically press the idea of, well, you know, Jesus said, I and the Father are one, does that, would that mean it's appropriate to refer to Jesus as the Father? I'm scared about how many people would go, oh, okay, yeah, right, no problem.